Men's turn now. Well, Green hasn't dominated like Jones. This is a real contest. He's drawn in lane five. Bolden's drawn in eight. Thompson in four and Chambers in three. They look to be the four main chances. You just wonder whether Bolden can get himself up. There's Darren Campbell, the European champion, going from lane one for Great Britain. Zakari, the African champion who put Matt Shervington out, goes in lane two from Ghana. What a season he's had. A chance Chambers, third a year ago, 1 year older at 22. And there's Obadeli Thompson. Third in the Commonwealth final behind Bolden and Fredericks. Shaded by Chambers in the semi-final. And here's the favourite, world record holder, double world champion. Nothing's changed for him. Well, John Drummond's done a good job to get through. So the three who share that apartment in Coogee together are running in the final. Drummond and Green and Bolden. Well, from the Caribbean, Kim Collins can't believe his luck here in the final. He's enjoying it.
He's one of the happiest finalists you've ever seen. He's happy to share it with everyone right at the moment. And the wait, others are waiting till they get across the line.
And a contrast with Azzo Bolden, who was disappointing in the semi. He's got to pick up the pieces 80 minutes later and try and run the race of his life. He was third 4 years ago behind Bailey and Fredericks.
Under enormous pressure from his country. Enormous pressure. Green's a bit susceptible in the cold. I don't think he's thinking about the cold right at the moment. He's thinking about gold.
4 years ago, he sat in the stands in Atlanta and cried when he watched the 100 metres. He was run out in the quarterfinal stage of the American Championships. Bolden injured last year, wanting this desperately to confirm his status as one of the great ones. And there's Campbell. And Green after that final, there's Thompson, took off and went to California to be coached by John Smith. In the last 32 years, only one American has won the 100 metres final, and that's Carl Lewis in 84 and 88. They have dominated the sprint, but Lewis is the only American since 1968 to win the men's 100. As Green goes down in lane five.
Remember, we've got to think about the start. It all has to be split section, second reaction. There's no room for mistakes here. This is the most important race of their life.
So they're almost set. Green four from the left. Oh, and again, Zakari, as I think he did in the semi-final, getting up and bringing a couple out with him.
It's always nerve-wracking when this happens.
Let's see lane two from the top of screen. Is Zakari coming out, and Bolden quick to move as well out in lane eight. Does it suit Bolden being so far away from Green and Thompson and Chambers, do you think?
It can either work for him or against him. He won't be distracted and he won't be there with them for the action. So whether he can focus on his own race and hold himself together, we will see.
When it comes to the Olympics, it is the heavyweight championship, this one. The men's 100 meter final. Some deep breaths, some composure, go through the routine and run the race of your life. Green. Who knows what he's going through right now, carrying the burden of favourite. Settle again. Almost set. Away, Green, good start. Bolden got a terrific start out wide. Green accelerates. Behind him, Chambers, and then Thompson. Green and Bolden, it's not going to be much in it. Green's got him now and moves away and runs 9.88. Confirms his greatness like Marion Jones with a brilliant win.
Once again, a delighted athlete. He's dominated that event. Drummond actually jumped in front of him, which which dragged Green through. He accelerated hard. He is brilliant through the middle of the race. We've got the two mates there, Green and Bolden.
They've run first and second, and Bolden's inside 10 as well. Bolden had a great first 60. 9.87 Green and 9.99 for Bolden. Thompson third in 10.04.
And there's
the trio. They come from different camps. Thompson is with Dan Pfaff from Texas, who trains Donovan Bailey and also Bruni Sorin. But it was the HSI group that John Smith trained, who have run first, second and fifth in the final. And he is a great one. There is no question about that. You've got to win an Olympic final to be one of the greats. He came in like Jones. Two world championships under his belt. The extra little bit with the world record. And to run 9.87 here tonight was absolutely brilliant.
Absolutely brilliant. You've still got to manage the pressure. There's nothing like an Olympic arena for things to go wrong. But nothing's gone wrong tonight here for Maurice Green. Everything's gone right. He's really getting his shoes off quickly for some reason. He must be going to throw them into the crowd. I don't think so. He's just kissing them and saying thank you.
Well, his acceleration through the middle of the race, it was, again, devastating. Bolden was right with him early, but Green put them all away. Here we go. Put your arms up, Raylene. We've got a chance.
Oh, I wouldn't mind a pair of those. That's most unusual these days with collectors paying a fortune for items like that. Drummond's away very well. So's Green, and Bolden on the outside. He's given himself every chance. Big arm action. He's really working hard, but Green has accelerated past Drummond. Thompson's coming through, but Green, look at him. Head down, working those arms hard. High knee lift, stretching right out, gathering every bit of ground he can with each stride. Bolden's not looking as good mid-race. He's not quite as relaxed, and he knows he's coming second. Green knows he's winning, and he's not going to slow up this time. Fantastic running. And Thompson coming through there for third.
And just taking out Chambers and Drummond at the end as we have a head-on look at Maurice Green.
Hands wide open, big left arm swing back at the start. You can see the tension in his face. He's squeezing every ounce of energy out and trying to get as much speed as he can. Up into full running, looking to the end of the track. The neck is really straining. His arms are swinging hard. We haven't seen him pump like this in any of the rounds. Looking fantastic. Knows he's won it. I'm a happy boy. No more stress.
Quick two, 9.87 and 9.99. Nobody under 10 going through. But Green tonight putting on a show. No man has come into an Olympic final as a double world champion, world record holder at their first Olympics with such a pedigree. And the Americans have had a brilliant night here where their two champions shining when it counts most. Jones and Green have been absolutely superb. They've given us something to remember forever. We've been pretty fortunate to see this tonight. Two great champions at the peak of their power and running away from the best that the world has to offer at this very moment. Flashes going off everywhere. Bolden away best. Green now trying to go up alongside of his mate Drummond. He's got his two flatmates outside of him. Thompson, he's got beaten. Chambers, he's got beaten. And now he moves away.
Bolden actually was up into full stride much earlier than Green. So Green's held the acceleration phase longer. But Green, there's no doubt, that stage of the race, 60 metres, 70 metres, 80 metres, no one can hold him. Bolden's disappointed, I'm sure. But a silver is better than a bronze.
And a word for Bolden, a third in 96 and a second here. He's confirmed that he's absolutely top class. There's Green in the middle. Next to him on his left, our rider's Obadeli Thompson, who's got three for third. Drummond alongside of Green. And now Green really puts on the power.
Yes, you can see he's still looking down. Tension in the neck. Driving hard. Magnificent run. Right time to do it.
Superb.